Hello guys, welcome to our channel Speaking Books. Here we will be discussing the chapter-wise summary of some famous best-selling books. Books enhance to gain experience from the great authors. This channel will help in gaining golden notes and quotes of famous authors through short summaries. So now, get your headphones and ready to gain knowledge. In this video, we are going to discuss about a best-selling book, Think and Grow Rich. A brief introduction about the book and the author. Oliver Napoleon Hill was an American self-help author. He is known best for his book Think and Grow Rich, published in 1937, and is among the 10 best-selling self-help books of all time. Before going through the introductory part of the book asks you a question. What do you want the most? Is it money, fame, power, contentment, personality, peace of mind, or happiness? The 13 steps to riches described in this book offer the shortest dependable philosophy of individual achievement ever presented for the benefit of the men and women who is searching for a definite goal in life. Now, let's know something about the book. This book conveys the experience of more than 500 men of great wealth who begin at scratch with nothing to give in return for riches except thoughts, ideas, and organized plans. It provides you with a perfect system of self-analysis that will readily disclose what has been standing between you and the big money in the past. It describes the famous Andrew Carnegie formula of personal achievement, by which he accumulated hundreds of millions of dollars for himself and made no fewer than a score of millionaires of men to whom he taught his secret. Since we don't know about Andrew Carnegie, let's take a quick look at his profile. Andrew Carnegie, Scottish-born American industrialist who led the enormous expansion of the American steel industry in the late 19th century. He was also one of the most important philanthropists of his era. This book was written by the men to whom Carnegie disclosed the astounding secret of his riches, the same men to whom the 500 wealthy men revealed the source of their riches. Perhaps you don't need all that is to be found in the book. No one of the 500 men from whose experiences it was written did, but you may need one idea, plan, or suggestion to start you toward your goal. Somewhere in the book, you will find this needed stimulus. Before beginning the book, author has left an important message for the readers, so let's go through that first. In every chapter of this book, mention has been made of money-making secret, which has made fortunes for more than 500 exceedingly wealthy men, whom I have carefully analyzed over a long period of years. The secret to which I refer has been mentioned no fewer than 100 times throughout this book. It has not been directly named, for it seems to work more successfully when it is merely uncovered and left in sight, where those who are ready and searching for it may pick it up. That is why Mr. Carnegie tossed it to me so quietly without giving me its specific name. If you are ready to put it to use, you will recognize this secret at least once in every chapter. I wish I might feel privileged to tell you how you will know if you are ready, but that would deprive you much of benefit you will receive when you make the discovery in your own way. Whether you receive the sign in the first or the last chapter, stop for a moment when it presents itself and turn down a glass, for that occasion will mark the most important turning point of your life. We pass now to chapter 1 and to the story of my very dear friend who has generously acknowledged having seen the mystic sign and whose business achievements are evidence enough that he turned down a glass. As you read his story and the others, remember that they deal with the important problems of life, such as all men experience. The problems arising from one's endeavor to earn a living, to find hope, courage, contentment, and peace of mind, to accumulate riches and to enjoy freedom of body and spirit. Remember too, as you go through the book, that it deals with the facts and not with fiction. Its purpose being to convey a great universal truth through which all who are ready may learn not only what to do but also how to do it and receive as well the needed stimulus to make a start. Thank you all. Make sure you like, subscribe and share. Please share your feedback in the comment section. Goodbye. Have a great day.